knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
So far, we have covered CD4 plus and CD8 plus T cells, but there are still more T cell subtypes to discuss. Alpha beta and gamma delta T cells represent two different T cell lineages that are defined by their expression of either alpha beta or gamma delta T cell receptors. Gamma delta T cells are a heterogeneous population of immune cells, and they constitute less than 5% of total T cells in mice lymphoid tissue and human peripheral blood. These cells are regarded as the bridge between innate and adaptive immune responses, owing to their unique features. In comparison with alpha beta T cells, very little is known about the detailed role and function of gamma delta T cells. Although they constitute the minority of the total population, gamma delta T cells are abundant in epithelial sites, constituting around 70% of skin dermal T cells, 40% of intestinal intraepithelial lymphocytes, or IELs, and 20% of T cells in the female reproductive organs. Here, they are known to carry out immune functions, help in tissue repair, and maintain mucosal homeostasis. This unique edge enables them to perform a variety of functions during homeostasis and disease. Alpha beta and gamma delta T cells originate from a common progenitor in the thymus. Bone marrow-derived hematopoietic stem cells migrate into the thymus, where Notch1 and DL4 signaling leads to the generation of T cell progenitors known as double-negative cells, which lack both CD4 and CD8 expression. Two models have been proposed so far to explain the mechanism behind gamma-delta T-cell lineage commitment, the signal strength model and the stochastic selective or pre-commitment model. The first model hypothesizes that the lineage fate is determined prior to rearrangement of TCR loci. On the other hand, the second model suggests that irrespective of TCR type, the signal originating from TCR determines the fate decision. A strong signal promotes commitment to the gamma delta T cell lineage, and a weaker signal directs the progenitors towards alpha beta lineage. The development and maintenance of gamma delta T cells and their subsets relies on the presence of IL-7 and IL-15. Growth of dermal gamma delta T cells preferentially requires IL-7, whereas IL-15 is essential for generating IEL gamma delta T cells. They are known as the unconventional T lymphocytes since they recognize a broad range of antigens without the presence of MHC molecules. They are capable of attacking target cells either directly through their cytotoxic activity or indirectly through the activation of other immune cells. They also participate in pathogen clearance, inflammation, and tissue homeostasis. Gamma delta T cells have been shown to participate in and execute effector functions during infection, malignancy, allergy, and autoimmune diseases. Interferon gamma and IL-17A are the major cytokines secreted by gamma delta T cells. Interferon gamma in this context is an essential determinant of anti-tumor response and immune response to microbial infections. IL-17A, produced by gamma delta T cells, promotes allograft rejection and influences inflammation during autoimmune encephalomyelitis. Growth factors secreted by gamma delta T cells, such as keratinocyte growth factor, or KGF, and insulin-like growth factor, or IGF, maintain epithelial and intestinal homeostasis by promoting damage repair. Immunoregulatory cytokines, such as IL-10 and TGF-beta, regulate CD4 plus T cell proliferation and function, and promote B cell antibody production. As mentioned before, gamma delta IELs constitute a major proportion of T cells in the mouse intestinal epithelial layer. Butyrophilin-like 1, or BTNL1, and 6, or BTNL6, are expressed on enterocytes to promote maturation and expansion of gamma delta T cells. During infection, gamma delta T cells secrete AMPs and help maintain the integrity of epithelium. Gamma delta T cells can provide extensive immunosurveillance to underlying pathogens through the epithelium. KGF secreted by gamma delta T cells helps in the proliferation and migration of epithelial crypt cells during homeostasis and intestinal pathology. Gamma delta T cells promote immune tolerance, producing immunoregulatory cytokine TGF-beta and inhibiting the function of cytotoxic T cells. Tumor-infiltrating gamma-delta T-cells have been demonstrated to be the most favorable prognostic immune population among many cancer types. However, a pro-tumor role for these cells in colorectal cancer has been reported. In this case, these cells are responsible for the chronic inflammation in CRC patients through IL-17 secretion. Gamma-delta T-cell subsets are very effective against pathogens which produce phosphoantigens. They also participate in various chronic inflammatory pathologies such as psoriasis and rheumatoid arthritis. And with that, we conclude our survey of all the different types of T cells, including CD4+, CD8+, alpha-beta, and gamma-delta T cells. Let's move forward and take a look at B cells next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.